lots of decluttering today, lots of reorganizing, because I am, well, decluttering number one, but also rearranging things so I can clear off at least one of those pantry shelves downstairs, because there's a lot of clutter on there and I'm just like over it. All right, well, I guess I'm gonna start in the closet with things that I can see. Yeah, I'm gonna start with that.
I am now going to attempt putting in this shelf in here. Wish me luck. Have the anchors in. Boy, that was pretty hard work. Like, I'm sweating right now, but it's almost done. Okay, so I got these in. Yeah, I'm just gonna drill some screws into the underneath so it's a little more stable, but I think it's pretty good.
I figured I would just start by pulling out things that I haven't looked at in a while. Now, this is a box of old taxes. I have already gone through all the more recent taxes, so I'm pretty sure everything in this box is over 10 years old and I'm gonna be able to shred it. So I'm gonna look through it real quick and see if there's anything that I need to keep from in here. But yeah, I'm pretty sure this can get decluttered, but we shall see. As I suspected, everything in here is ancient old. I mean, as you can see, I have some tax returns from the 90s, 1997, 1999. I know I saw 98 in here. I mean, yeah. These are the tax documents with like my social and all that, so I can shred these. Everything else was just old receipts, so that's that. Yay! Just decluttered a whole box that has been sitting in my closet for 15 years, needlessly. Awesome!
So I'm going to be prepping the floor and hopefully installing these peel and stick self-adhesive tiles today to replace the nasty floor that's in here right now. We do have a serious challenge here because of this situation. So the old vinyl is like definitely not still stuck. This is all coming up. And that is a situation because it has to be flat, but I don't want to pull up all the old vinyl if I can help it. Okay, so this is gonna take a little bit of thinking, but that's okay because Tinos never give up and we certainly never surrender. Got a lot to do. Okay, so first things first, I think I'm going to take up the vinyl that's come up already. So let's start with that. Oh, I'm scared. This is like way bigger of a project than at first I was like, oh, we'll just put down the tiles, but then realized no, it's not that easy because of this old vinyl situation. And technically I should take all of the old vinyl up in order to have a completely level surface, but yeah, I really don't want to do that. Like, yeah, no, that's not happening. So again, this is not a DIY tutorial by any means. Definitely a renegade rebel situation over here. So yeah, definitely don't recommend anything that I end up doing. Okay. This is, okay, wait. Oh, okay, oh my god. Well, first of all, let's get some of this dirt out of here. So I have this straight edge. I feel like the sticky kind of ends about here. I'm gonna use this existing see, this tile fits this tile, so I'm gonna use the existing floor to line up with this so I don't have to mess with lines and things like that. I'm gonna cut it halfway so that it gives a little bit more room for the cut to be under the majority of this. I don't know if that makes sense, but we'll see. Okay. So, because I don't want to cut it here because then there's not as much, I don't know, anyway. This is not no professional job. The glue really stops right here. Okay. Let's see. But like I said, I don't want to stop it here because then it'll just be better. Oh wow, you really have to dig in there. Okay, let me try this. This part down here will be under the baseboard, so it should help keep that down. All right, this is good. Okay, this may or may not look successful, but I think we're in good shape here for what I was planning on doing to solve the issue of the ripped, torn up stuff, but not taking it all off.
Now these are photos. I want to say, like, for me, photos really is not a big clutter thing. I don't consider photos clutter per se. Like, having them organized and stuff is great, but yeah, these are just photos. Like, maybe I can digitalize some of these, but I, you know, like I said, I'm okay with a box of photos. I could go through these and, you know, see if there's anything I want to get rid of, but in consideration of time for this video, I'm not going to go through this box right now, but I will consider going through that and digitalizing things and or like getting rid of stupid things that, like, you know, the blurry picture, the picture of the floor that, you know, because all of those were taken with a real camera. Same with these. Okay, these are all my headshots from when I was in LA. Long time ago. I think it was 24 in this picture. I was also 24 in this picture. Maybe 25. 24, 25, not sure. Okay. But in any case, I am no longer in LA. I am no longer 25. I no longer need a whole box of headshots, a black and white headshots. So I'm gonna keep a few of them just, you know, for posterity's sake. I don't know, whatever. Not like I need them, but I will keep some just to have some. The other ones, yeah, I'll just let the other ones go because I really don't need an entire huge box full of these. Okay, so I'll just keep a few. There's more than a few here, but this is plenty. And all of these can just get recycled. I'll save more than enough. That makes me feel totally comfortable. I'm totally fine with that. And these can go bye-bye. I need to find something. Let's see. I was gonna declutter this envelope, but I will keep it and put these in there. Okay, done and done. I feel totally fine with this. I'll fit that in there. I'll shove it in. I'll make it fit. It's not really fitting, but I can at least, yeah. Okay, so at least now all the photos are in one box. This box is decluttered now. And then, so this is all the photos. I probably need like an actual bin for these so they don't get like bugs and stuff in them, but we'll see. I don't have one handy right now, but I'm sure I'll be able to rustle one up at some point. Okay, moving on.
I have to use the vacuum and I notice it's really dirty, so I'm gonna clean it. And I figured it's a really good vacuum and it should be taken care of. While I have it out, I might as well clean it. Okay, how does this work? Oh, that's easy. Okay, and clean the floor. Oh, whoa! Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Something different. Okay. Anything else? I guess that's it. Wash this off really quick. Oh, actually. So hopefully you can do this. I'm not doing anything else but my vacuum. Oh, hey dear. Okay, there's a lot more stuff in there than I was expecting. Okay. Uh-oh. Now that sure does make it easier. Okay. Wait. Oh, I should have worn a mask. It's pretty dusty over here. Okay, well, I guess I'll...
like a generation 1 or 2 iPad that got wet one day, and I don't know whatever happened to the charger. Pretty sure this is completely kaput, So I can get rid of this. I don't know why I'm even holding on to it. I have all of these Apple Loop jam pack things. So I think I can declutter the boxes. Yeah, I'll just keep the discs. And then instead of having all of this in this huge box, I can use this for the photos. Because I don't want to get rid of the discs. Like, they're good still if I want to install them. If I ever decide I want to utilize GarageBand loops again. Wow, I have some old programs here. I'm not really sure. I don't know if I still need these or not. But again, not cheap. I don't know. I guess I'm just going to hold on to these for a moment because I really don't. Yeah, like, wow. Just this one box was $100. So that's not bad. I mean, this whole thing was full and now I'm down to this. I mean, that's, I don't know if that counts as decluttering so much as throwing away trash. I don't know. But it's less. So I'm going to take it as a decluttering win. These are music CDs. They are labeled. I think I'm going to go through these because now that I think of it, it's like John Mayer. Like, I don't like him, actually. So I have this, but it's like, I don't like his music. Sorry, any John Mayer fans out there. But I don't personally like his music too much. So why would I keep this burnt CD of his music when if I wanted to, I can listen to it on Apple. Annie DeBranco, no. Jack Johnson, blank. These are all blank. These have numbers 37 through 50. Okay, so I think what these are mixtapes. Definitely old music. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna get rid of all of these. I'm glad I went through them. Okay, tip. When you think you don't want to go through something, just go through it anyway, because instead of holding on to this for however long more, I'm decluttering it. It's going, it's bye. Just because I took what, like a minute to go through them, you know, that's like, tells me, okay, don't be lazy, Tracy. You know what I mean? Like sometimes you just think, yeah, I'll just keep them. It's fine. But it's like, no, keep, like I said in my last video, keep the big picture goal in mind, right? It's all these little things that like add up, you know, it's like you think, oh, it's just a little bit. It's just these little CDs, but it's these little CDs. It's this box. It's that box. It's this pile. It's that pile. It's this bin. It's that bin. It's this shelf. It's that. And after a while, all of these little things like really, really add up. So yeah, I took a minute, went through it, realized I don't need or want any of these. This whole stack can completely go. And that is really, it's like a really freeing thought. I can just take a minute and like then realize I can let all of this go with zero emotion whatsoever. And also it makes me wonder like, why am I holding on to such weird things too? Like sometimes I think like, it's not logical or rational. It's just like emotional. But like emotional, not based in rational thought. You know what I mean? It's like emotions that you just kind of hold on. I don't know. It's, I'm getting better though. Like I'm definitely seeing the patterns and I'm definitely able to talk myself through these things and really detach emotionally from the situation and just look at it from a realistic goal-oriented, goal-focused viewpoint. Win.
Before I clean the floors really good, I decided I'm going to cut the door jambs. That way it's much easier to just slide the tile under it and it's a much cleaner look than trying to cut the tile around the door jamb. And I do, of course, have my safety goggles. But I'm gonna do this off camera because safety first, I need to concentrate, so I'll be right back. Okay, so door jambs, see, so now the, oh, this one maybe I need to cut that a little bit more. But you can see, you can slide the stuff under there. Shoot. I didn't quite get this part good enough. Okay. Oh, yeah, there, I just do these. Apply the concrete primer. So this has to dry for like 2 hours once it's on, and then we'll be almost ready. Okay, so about 2 hours, and then I can clean the floors, and then can start putting in the tile.
That bin is now full of my photos, which is what I wanted, a plastic bin. So that's good. And then these, I'll have to figure out a situation with that. Oh, look it, I missed one. Oh, I'm like 14 in this picture, I want to say. Oh dear. Styles back in the 80s. Okay, I'm going to put the wine education in the hall closet because I don't need to access that quickly or easily. This actually goes downstairs in the fire lockbox, and this is full and nasty and can get recycled. So I'll be honest, I was not planning on decluttering this bin of clothes any further at this point. However, what I realized is if I declutter this a little bit more, I can fit these shoes in there, and then I will, one, have two less bins in the closet, taking up a lot of space, and two, I will have two new bins to put other things in that might need a bin. These bras, I am gonna get really real with myself and say, okay, what size are these? They are 36B. I am in like a 42 right now. This would take a darn near miracle. Are they all 36B? Like, whoa. 38B. Okay, so I'm gonna get rid of any 36Bs for sure. I'm ready, you know, I'm ready to declutter these. I thought about it. It's just like kind of silly to hang on to these things that like don't fit, haven't fit in 4 years. Definitely the 36s though. That is like so far from where I am right now that I don't know, I just don't see it happening. And if it does, great. I get to treat myself to new bras. Awesome. Are we okay with keeping two? I think I am. I'm okay with keeping two. And all these other ones can get donated and that will be fantastic. Okay, great. Okay, I'm very happy with this. It's actually less full than it even was before. Shoes are on here and then decluttered down to one bin.
Okay, it's been 3 hours for the primer to dry and I've mopped the floor, cleaned the floor, so nice and clean. And it's time to start doing the tiles. I'm a little nervous. It shouldn't be too hard, I would think. But I am going to probably not talk because I need to focus. Yeah, I need to focus. So I'm not gonna talk through this and you can listen to some fancy music. Wish me luck.
Here's where we're at right now. I've got all this space cleared, kind of organized-ish. All of that is cleared, organized-ish. So yeah, I'm happy with the state of the closet right now. I did declutter some stuff. I did move a few things around. I think I'm ready to start bringing pantry item things up because the hall closet is pretty darn empty right now, and I don't really want to move anything out of there into here if I don't have to. I think the next step is going to start actually bringing the pantry stuff that I want to keep in the hall closet up. So yay, making progress.